It wasn't bad. We qualified P2. I was just a touch off Christian all day in practice, and then was able to get the heat race win, which was nice, and got to really line up where I wanted on the gate, and I just didn't quite execute the start as good as I wanted to. Jett got ahead of me just a touch and was able to control the inside, so that was kind of the race right there. And the track was a little difficult to pass, and it was so slick. Like, the moisture started to come up as, like, the longer the night went, it seemed like the slicker and slicker it got. So that made it tough. Like, I had a big mishap where I about died over that little section right before the Supercross triple, so that was scary. But overall, man, I can't complain. I got some points on second place, and that's always a good thing. I just was a little bummed on my riding. I just felt really flat at the beginning of the race and didn't have much intensity there, so that's why I was a little frustrated with that. But overall, we got a long break now, so I'm gonna try to enjoy things and get some outdoor riding and come back in a few months. So final round, heading into the little break that we have, done and dusted. Orlando One was good. Started off as a pretty weird day with the rain and the weather forecast that we had. Dumping down pretty good, some thunder and lightning, and it passed through us. They uncovered the track, and the schedule changed a little bit with practice being pushed back a little bit, but it was cool. Did my best qualifying time, or qualified my best into the night show, qualifying ninth, and then my heat race, had a nice gate, and came out of the gate good, and was, I don't know exactly, but I was somewhere in the mid pack and ended up making a few passes through some big rhythms, and then ended up fifth or sixth in that. So it qualified me straight into the heat, or the main, which I'm super pumped, made all my mains so far straight out of the heat race. And then going into the main, had a really good gate, got a super good jump, and going into the corner, I was up in the top area, and then everyone kind of swarmed around me, and then just kind of tried to ride smooth, and I knew it was going to be a long race. The track got really, really technical, and I just made sure just to try and hit my marks, don't make any mistakes, and it was good. I ended up sixth on the night, my best season finish. I'm stoked to go into the break, ending it on sixth, and eighth overall in points, so I'm stoked with that, and we'll see you guys in April.
Hey, what's up? This is Shane McElrath. My weekend went okay for my 450 Supercross debut. It was a big day for myself, for the Smart Top Bullfrog Spas Honda team. Man, it's a stacked class out there, and I really didn't know what to think coming in. I knew I was at a little bit of a deficit coming in at round seven to be my first round, but it was a lot of fun. We had a little bit of weather to deal with early, but I think the track turned out awesome for the night show. Qualifying went pretty good. Try to just do my own thing in practice and just try to get a good time in, and that led to a good gate pick for the heat race, and I ended up pulling the hole shot in the heat race and led a few laps. So it was pretty wild during that. I was trying to calm down a little bit because it was pretty crazy to be leading there, but I mean, I felt like I'm capable of doing that. It was just crazy that it was already happening. So we got some good building blocks to build from. Obviously, I think I ended up 17th. There was a lot going on in that main event, and a lot of it kind of caught me off guard. I mean, some of those positions I've never been in my racing career. So it's going to be a learning curve, but it's something that can be tackled. So I'm looking forward to building from here on out. And I think we're going to keep getting better. I think we have a lot of potential, and I'm excited to grow and to get better. So thanks.
Started off pretty good. You know, I think this is one of my better days overall. Started off practice pretty hot. Ended up qualifying 11th, but you know, I was on the board there for just a second, and it was so good. I think that's kind of a confidence booster. But, you know, went out for the heat race, didn't get the greatest start, didn't take the greatest gate. And then, you know, I got stuck. Got stuck behind a bunch of people, and then, you know, qualified, or got eighth in the heat race. And then, you know, went out in Maine, had 16th gate pick, was way outside. Jumped the gate, and then got a decent start for how bad my jump was. And then, you know, I just pushed and pushed. Got hung up on the first lap, and I think I was in like 17th going across the finish line. But, you know, I just put my head down, charged, rode my own race, didn't focus on anything but me. And, you know, it worked out. And got up to six. So, one behind my career best, and started 17th. So, that should give me some confidence going out for this next week. And I like the track. It was definitely hard packed and not what I thought it was going to be when I saw their forecast this morning. So definitely different, but it shaped up for my liking. And yeah, I'm stoked to get back here next Saturday. And I think I got more to prove.
Hi, Don. From the heat race, I started out pretty good. I kind of jumped before the gate drop and was able to go around the first corner, third, and just made passes really quick on the whoop section and try to follow Colt Nichols, but I did a couple of mistakes and he pulled me away, and which I finished second. It was not too bad. And for a main event, I slipped off the gate, which was a really bad start. Came around the first corner, mid-pack, I guess. And again, trying to make passes for first couple laps, and I was able to get to fourth. But Christian, Jett, and Colt was in front of me, and it was kind of hard for me to catch them. I was catching Craig a little bit every lap, but I made one huge mistake on whoop section, which got me a wind knockout out of myself, and I couldn't breathe for four corners. And yeah, and after that I had to slow down and just finish with fourths for the night. But yeah, it was okay.
Hey, Vince Rizzi here. Just finished up Orlando One. Not the best night. Had a decent heat race, got a sixth, and had myself in a good position in the main event. I was fifth, and I got rear-ended up the wall and stalled it, and I think went back to about 15th. So that wasn't ideal. Kind of takes the wind out of my sails too, and going from being in fifth and feel like I got a good race going and dropping back so far. But we got another one to go here this weekend. Staying in Florida, I like it here. We're gonna do some riding in Florida and see if we can't improve next weekend.
What's up, Zach Osborne here. The recap of Orlando round one. Pretty decent night for me. Ended up pretty good. Had some difficulties in practice and just wasn't really that on point, but was able to get a good start there in the main event. Take my first whole shot of the season and also my first podium. So looking forward to Orlando 2 and moving forward with some momentum.
Yeah, the weekend started off great. Qualified first. Man, I love this track. Everything about it, the dirt. Man, it was hard to catch, just like the test track, so I was feeling so good. Got off to a good start in the heat race, and second lap, some sort of little case turned into a big ball. I'm sure everyone's kind of seen it on TV, but yeah, I banged up my hand pretty good. I wasn't sure I was even going to race. I was feeling some stuff clicking there that shouldn't be clicking. But we had it taped up by Dr. G, and I had to grit it. I knew I had to do what I could to get through the tonight, because we have 7 weeks after this. I can heal up after. It's just getting through tonight. And I was able to get out to a good start from way on the outside from the main, and I got into third quick. And then I stayed with Colt for a lot of the race. And then had some sketchy moments with my hand, just kind of started losing grip and riding a little tight, so I backed it off and finished third. Only lost 2 points to Colt, so man, if, after the heat race, if you would have asked me, if I would have told me I got third, I would have been jumping up and down. So it was a win in my books after that crash. But we got a long break, so I can heal up and get ready for Salt Lake.
Cool, thanks Christian.
Hey guys, Jett Lawrence here, just got finished up with the night, and it went a pretty smooth day. I felt like I rode pretty smart in the I made some smart decisions in the quali practices and was P3 in both of them. I felt like I I just needed to be where I needed to be, and I felt like I was smarter with that. And going in the heat race, I didn't get a very good start. I popped the clutch a little too hard, which made me wheelie out, but I was able to kind of manage the first turn and get a little further up in the pack. But end up winning that with Craig going down, so I got pretty lucky on that. But going into the main event, really executed my start very well, and I was able just to manage the race from the start to the checkers. I felt like it was a H2 ride. I had Colt ride on me, so it was good to kind of have the pressure there and keep me on it. So but no, I'd like to thank the team and my mechanic Christian for all the support, and my trainer Johnny. So yeah, we've been working really hard, and it's good to leave on a good note. So thanks to them, and I can't wait for Salt Lake.
I would say day was great. You know, being back home in Florida, just had a good qualifier. I think we had a P3 and then a heat race. Didn't have the best start, but made some passes. I think we might have gotten 5th or 6th, something like that. And main event had a decent start and just made a few mistakes. I think just I wasn't driving with the track that well, but even when I was getting pounded to the ground just myself, I felt like I still, you know, managed to finish something and went up 9th. So overall, you know, I guess I would say that the day wasn't a bad day. I can only say it's a great day because, you know, we could have been worse. You know, a lot of guys went down. You know, a lot of guys were, you know, definitely fatigued and, you know, having problems, things like that. You know, I just would say we just rode a solid 9. That's the best that I can say. And we're gonna dig deep, you know. We're gonna keep finding our way, and you know, we know what we're capable of. And let's just get back up in those top 5s and get this box. You know, I know it's definitely, we're all right there. It's just a matter of when and where. But I think we're a little seven, about to be 8 rounds in now, or a little over halfway now, and it's time. So I'm ready to do it. And back to Orlando again. Orlando 2.0.
Orlando One, not the greatest weekend practice. I felt okay, you know, put laps together. That clay dirt was really hard, actually, even though with all the rain we got, you know, those guys, the crew track did a great job again, and we were able to ride in great conditions considering the amount of rain we got. So it was good. We actually had 2 practices, which is, you know, fine, fine with that. And then, but I was like top 15, you know, I was riding decent, but you know, I was pretty far back. So a little bit disappointed with that, but I knew I was going to do better than that on the, for the races. And on the heat race, I had a decent start, and I was third, and I ended up third on the heat race, so which was good, you know, for the gate pick. I was okay with that. I went inside on the gate, so like looking for to a good start, and unfortunately maybe did too much over the gate, and then I went sideways. I spun over, I think over the gate, like the, not the grid, but over the plastic. I might have spun and went sideways, and it killed my momentum and my start, and I was dead last. So super disappointed with that. And man, I was like, that's exactly what I didn't want to do, and unfortunately, but that's racing. And and then I put my head down and then try my best to come back and then pass, you know, those guys one at a time, be patient and try different lines obviously to make passes. I was going all the way to the left on the whoops, and I was pretty consistent. I wasn't too bad. I actually make it up sometimes compared to other guys. So I was pumped on that, and the rest of the track, man, it was tough. It was hard, a little bit slick, and very choppy, so very challenging for the body, the bike. Came back to 7th. That's all I had. So yeah, definitely looking to start up front and battle with the top guys like I did, you know, before. And like last weekend, for example, I was in a little bit better position. So I'm looking for that, and for Orlando too.
What's up, guys? Better weekend for me. Finished P14, felt like I made some progress. I'm gonna do some work this week with the team here in Florida and hopefully come out swinging for Orlando too. But just want to thank everybody for the team, from the team, and yeah, excited.
Orlando was a different kind of race. They delayed the schedule due to possible rain and lightning, so we only had two qualifying practices, and all three times we had completely different types of dirt. The first practice was kind of sketchy because it was super hard pack on the jumps, and from the water sitting at the bottom, it was wet and soft at the bottom, so it ended up being really slick and tricky. But going into the night show, we felt pretty decent and was able to get a hole shot and a heat race win, which set us up nicely for the night show, and grabbed another good start there. Not quite a hole shot, but I was in the top three and was battling up there, and Cooper ended up getting by me, and I was basically just me and him battling the whole time all the way to the end. It wasn't quite enough for the win, but in the end, I was still happy with the second spot as the track was a little tricky, and was happy to keep the rubber side down, and we have a second place for the night, which is good, and hopefully turn it around for Orlando 2 and see if we can get back on the top step.